I don't often get to do this because this is the role, this is for our principal, Mrs. Pearson. Unfortunately, she could not be with us tonight because she's teaching a class at Carthage. So if you want a really good teacher, if you're interested in being a teacher, go to Carthage. Sign up for Mrs. Pearson's course. Welcome to the fourth grade musical Rats. We've been working hard since the first week of school. Your children that you love are going to be absolutely fabulous. Please enjoy them. All we ask is that you don't block this middle aisle, because we do some coming and going from there. But you know, feel free to take pictures, to record, to do whatever it is you want to do to capture this moment. And I'm just stalling while I see the last of our audience members filing in. I want to tell you, it's been a real treat working with your particular group of kids. I may say this all the time and not know it, but this was the best group ever to work with. They are creative. They are so supportive of each other. They are engaging. They're quite talented, this group. All right, are we good to go? Okay, without further blah, blah, blah for me, enjoy the fourth grade musical, Rats.
A long time ago, a time before airplanes and cars and buses and trains.
A time before television, CD players, computers, and video games. There is a quaint little village in the Green Valley and the gently flowing river.
Artists came from miles around to paint pictures of its valley with its river and village because it was so beautiful.
And the name of the village was Hamlin.
In fact, there goes one now. It's Mr. Rye. He baker, everyone loves its rolls if they can get them done before the rats do.
And there's Miss Lily Spoon. She's the town librarian. Good morning, Miss Lily Spoon.
Why, hello, dear. Have you seen the book of the three blind mice? It's disappeared from the library and I can't find it anywhere.
She cut off their tails? Oh, no!
Miss Lily Spoon? I found your book. Oh, well.
Look, here comes Constable Blarney. He's the policeman in the village, and he keeps order in our little village. Hello, Constable Blarney.
Why, hello. Tis a fine morning. I'd love to stay and chat, but I need to go open up the office. Oh dear, I seem to have misplaced my keys. I know I had them when I reached the corner.
Goodbye, Constable Blarney.
Oh, there's Miss Finney. She runs the bank. Hello, Miss Finney.
Good morning. I'm off to the bank to deposit more money. Best place for your hard-earned money, the bank. Very secure, yes, sir. You can rest easy and then your money is safe with me. Well, I've got to be off. Busy ahead of me. Sorting money, counting money, protecting money. A banker's job is never done.
And that's the town of Hill.
Wait, don't forget the children.
Oh, yes, the children. How could we forget the children?
There's Lisa and Tommy and Billy and Jimmy and Wendy and Susan.
Thank you.
problem here? Okay, just settle down. I'll get on the case right away, as soon as I can find my keys.
Oh, it's been comfortable. That's what you said the last time, and the time before that.
I would know that you were really trying to get rid of those rats.
But there were just too many of them.
The situation is completely out of hand.
Where's the mayor? The mayor's got to do something.
We want the mayor!
And what is so special about you?
watch and listen.
quiet.
No more squeaking. Are they all really gone?
It's true. No more rats.
We owe it all to our mayor and town council. Let's hear it now. Hip hip.
Hooray!
Hip hip.
Hooray!
Hip hip.
Hooray!
Thank you, one and all. Now back to normal and wonderful lives.
Thank you. you doing?
Billy, wake up!
Okay, kids, this is very funny, but you can stop now.
Someone do something?
I can't get her to wake up. Children, children.
I don't think they can hear us.
It's very sad.
Yes, I know.
Well, that's it. That's the end of the story.
They didn't live happily ever after.
And the children stayed frozen forever. All because the mayor didn't live up to her promise.
Oh well, thanks for coming.
Oh, hold on there. Just kidding. Boy, did we have them fooled.
We did? What? Oh yeah, here's what really happened. Well, the townspeople discovered that the mayor had gone bad on her agreement with the Pied Piper.
You gone bad on your agreement?
They sent her.
You did not keep your promise.
They sent her.
Shame!
As we were saying, they sent the mayor off with her money to find the Pied Piper.
Hey, Piper! Go, go!
And when she found the Pied Piper, she begged her to forgive her bad behavior and take the money that was owed her.
And the Pied Piper did just that.
But as they began their return trip, the Piper played a few notes, and the mayor found herself singing the children's song all the way back to him.
Listen, I believe I hear the mayor return now.
Time.
You were a wonderful audience. Let's give them one more round of applause. Totally see why I'm telling you this is the best group ever to work with, right? I mean, they're brilliant. I want to thank Mr. Gideon, here to go. The fourth grade teacher, Mr. Gideon. So we appreciate that flow. I also want to thank Ms. Petkus, who's not here with us tonight, but this phenomenal scenery that you see, the kids made that too. So as part of their lesson in art, they all learned about scene design. They all made their own 3D set and designed their own Hamlet, and then they took from there to make our set design. It was a great learning process for them. They did a great job. And most importantly, I want to thank their incredible music director and choreographer, Ms. Shile. About what we did. Since we've never done it at night before, you guys are the first, did you know that? Mine's the first year. We've never done any performance. So I'm gonna give you a chance to think about what it was like helping your student learn their lines, pick and design their own costumes, hear them learning their songs, their choreography, and just think, is there anything you wanna know? We'll give you an opportunity to ask a question. I see we have a plant here, it's a student and a sibling. What do you want to know, Donnie?
On a scale of 1 to 10, how fun would you say that the rivers are?
You can all show your hands.
Okay, put your numbers up. Those of you who are 1 or 10. Remember, my love and affection is dependent upon your answer. Okay, good. No pressure. Thanks, Donnie. They're all at 10. Actually, I think some of them have 11 fingers. Anybody else have a question? Yes, sir.
I was wondering if the mayor learned any lessons.
Is your mic working?
Well, I really didn't. I was taught to keep my promises, but I didn't really learn that.
Good answer.
Jitsu. Mail means to knock the stand for the microphone down.
I actually did. I was trying to fake angry, so yeah.
So this is how fun it is to work with your kids. So originally, it wasn't. And then one day, the mayor went from one comfort level, this is what's so fun about working with kids in the theater, and then, you know, they jumped leaps and bounds, and she just stormed up there and flung it down, and we're all like, yeah, let's keep that, that's good. I have one. I noticed there was a question earlier about what's in the money bags. Anybody want to know? Where's my Eva?
There was no money in the actual bag. There was just some coats and newspapers.
But I think they really did a good acting job, because can you raise your hand back there, that little boy who's by the money bags? Raise your hand. No. So I know, I don't mean to put you on the spot, but I know because I'm back there. You kept like trying to get close to that money bag and see if I noticed, because I think he was trying to steal some money. That's good acting. Yes, you have a question? Oh, this is new.
When did this tradition
this is our 17th production here at Dimensions of Learning, and we now have settled on 4 plays, and it's a really cute tradition. So this group saw this production when they were kindergartners, and then they do it in 4th grade. And then this afternoon, I don't know that we have any of our 8th graders here, but then, we do. So stand up, former rats. So these guys did it when they were 4th graders, and it was so cute, they've been bugging me for a month. Can we please sing the finale with them? They said, we don't want to take it away from them, but we'll work out a time during their music class where they can all come together and sing the finale.
I just want to add that real quick, because one thing that I noticed doing this, and I've been here 10 years now, and I'm like, wow. It's really amazing and fascinating and wonderful, and it says a lot about who we are as a school and how we act as a community, because I cannot tell you how many times, because, again, this is the first time we've been here, but we've always done this Wednesday afternoon, and the whole school is here, and the whole school is watching. And invariably, without question, without a doubt, I can sneak a look and look all the way back, and there are the 8th graders, and they're all doing the movements. And it's great.
So we like our traditions. I don't want to keep you too long. I know it's a really cool night. Oh, I got one more hand, and I think this will be our final, and then we'll let you take pictures. And your kids do need to wind up back in the classroom, because that's where their coats are.
Yeah.
We're going to go downstairs to do that.
When you guys went to Phantom of the Opera, what did you learn from that at the Marcus Theater that you brought back to your performance tonight?
Actually, what we learned out of that was that you guys gotta make like different choices when you got choices to make.
Good. Gotta make good choices, right, Xander? So we do like to bring it all curriculum together. They do go to the plays in first stage. The actors from first stage come and work with us as well. And they had a 2-day workshop with them. And I'm going to let Mr. Gideon tell you how that helped our play.
These kids started asking the very nice lady who came to give the workshop and started asking questions. And the questions led around to the whole acting thing. And it got to the point where I just went in and said, you know what, they're actors. They're all doing this performance in December. And what would be really great while you're here is if you could have a little acting workshop with them and teach them how professional actors act. And we first started out with probably what I, you know, my opinion, what do I know? What we needed the most, and that was the crowd scenes. And I asked the lady, how do you be a crowd? Can you teach these kids how to be a crowd on stage? And it was really neat, because before, they were just sort of standing there trying to figure out what to do, and, you know, by the end, like, okay, be angry. No, at me, give me the shots, the whole bit.
Talk all night. It's been a great learning opportunity. We do it, you know, we're a thinking school and we work on our thinking skills, and so we always focus on thinking. And to be able to get up in front of people and remember your lines and remember your choreography and remember your blocking and then have three adults talking at you while you're doing it saying, no, 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 go upstage left. Oh, first we had to learn what upstage left was. You know, I mean, it's a real learning experience that I know will benefit them whether they ever step foot on stage or not, because they have the great experience of being comfortable in front of an audience and communicating, thinking about what it takes for people to hear what you're saying. So I want to give them one more round of applause. Through the regular doors, they are dog down, so they can get in the classroom and get their stuff, but we're just gonna let you take your kids as you need to, all right? Does that work for you? All right, you want them in a group picture? Cast picture? Okay, guys.